Blood in your head thrums and pounds. That pounding blood obscures who you are. An overwhelming loss of memory. How you ended up amidst these hellish flames is just as hidden. You have nothing in your skull, besides your name and a headache. But you are in danger. Time to get out of here. And then you can shed light on the dark of the matter of yourself.
My head. Not getting back in that thing. Dead. Good.
This is the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye. The casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble.
How much further can I go?
Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind.
We are here. Here.
Cursed to put my hands on everything. Still alive. So that's progress.
We are trapped.
Save for discussion.
Yes! You've come to save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please, before they return! They return.
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer, a minion of the mind flayers who abducted you.
Remove us.
From this body.
From this case. Free us.
Please.
Apart from this strange context, you notice nothing unusual about the brain. An opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient should it prove a threat. Your fingers twitch with the desire to rip its tender, moist meat to shreds.
Wind Flayer horticulture.
Rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? Squall. You are no thrall. Flakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. We carry Mind Flayer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geich, Mind Flayers. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane.
No failure.
You proved surprisingly adequate in battle. Now, to the helm.
As bad as it could have. I've a lot on my mind. And, well, in it. Looking ahead. My way.
please. Let's see what this does.
Odd. I feel better.
Ship won't be able to take another dragon attack. We need to get out before it's too late. Pave my path with corpses. Build my castle with bones.
Construction is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
This ship is crashing. Do you intend to die for a stranger? Thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness because you have a gith with you.
You keep dangerous company. More that gith have a problem with everyone else. But there's more important matters right now. Survival. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Shadowheart. One moment. It's nothing. Trust me.
Enough of this chatter. We need to get to the helm. Now!
She's right. Lead on. Something the matter? Besides the obvious, that is. Well, jumping overboard is hardly an option. So that leaves us with taking control of this ship. Provided we can figure out how to do that, of course. I'm right behind you.
Woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you. Dazed woman.
I hear something. Voices.
I hear nothing of the sort.
As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod, commanding the person inside to change. Stares at you, weak and dazed.
Here we go.
Once inside, do as I say. Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment.
Kanyank.
Blood comes easy these days.
I will ascend.
what we have here. Got to move.
Still breathing, despite everything. Survival is all that matters. What's hiding here?
Something useful.
Stay idle.
on the move. What should I do? Worth a shot.
The Helm's alien transponder. You've made it in time. You half expected your memories to return once you were free of the Mind Flayership. But your past is still an aching void. If you don't find a way to remove the tadpole burrowed in your brain soon, your future will be as blank as your past. Your head whispers vengeance. You cannot wait to slice your way forth, seeking whatever wrought this tragedy upon you.
Mind my step. What's inside?
You drink in the pungent corpse. Since you awoke on the ship, your mind has been cold and empty, but something stirs. With your hands close to this body, you know nothing of why, but you find a half-smile flittering across your face. As soon as you delve into your mind, it is filled with flashes of a thousand different dead. There is something unknown and unspeakable deep within your heart.
alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? True. Seems like we're the lucky ones, judging by all the corpses strewn about. I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby.
I'll take that. Give it a shot.
now?
Never wanted the easy path.
Better stay back. One strike could be lethal.
They're dying for me. All of them.
I've got to concentrate. Heading there. Ikki!
Nothing important is ever easy. Stand in my way. Cutting to the chase. So much for peace.
Let's do this.
Still on my feet.
Survival isn't such a distant prospect.
Let's have a look.
Seems like a good moment to talk.
You strike me as the reliable sort. But are you sure this is a good idea?
Outside threats, perhaps? Each hour that passes, the thing inside us grows. We need to find a healer. Let's wake up at first light. Maybe we'll get lucky. We're overdue some good fortune. Rest well. We'll need our strength.
Something the matter?
There's no story. None that you're entitled to hear, anyway. Just forget you ever saw it.
I understand why you ask, but memory loss is not as uncommon as you'd think. There may be other causes.
We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly? I must admit, you've been a surprise, and not an unpleasant one. Kindred spirits are few and far between for me.
Besides, you saved my life aboard the Nautiloid. How can I do anything but sing your praises? I suppose we'd go our separate ways. Not a slight on your company, of course. Home. Baldur's Gate. There's someone waiting for me there. Someone I have to reach. As soon as possible. Thank you. And you're right. It's a delicate matter. Not something for light conversation.
Fine. What's on your mind?
What's hiding here? Have to keep going. Here goes nothing.
With sickly dreams, a deep dread floods you. Though you have a tadpole, you know your broken mind is not like the others who bear the worm. A few scraps of the past come back to you now and then, and you can never quite tell where the knowledge comes from. Inexplicable, violent yearnings overwhelm all other thoughts. Who could you possibly be to be their vessel? Waking up, hearing the pounding war drum of blood. How much you treasured the sight of the first corpse you touched. How cruel your old life must have been. What could have happened to make you forget? As you fall asleep, you are a shivering and shaking mess. Blood. 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 Blood.
free. I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it?
Just a dumb boar. You're relieved. Until you see the flash of a dagger.
Don't we? I saw you in the ship. Free. Scuttling about. You're in league with them, aren't you? Those tentacled... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light. The fear.
What was that? What's going on? The worm. Of course. That explains things, somewhat. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. Indeed we are. Please, allow me to introduce myself. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. A pleasure. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Well, yes, of course. But first things first. You know, I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
As he joins your side, your mind dances with thoughts of a perfect, pretty corpse.
There. A mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Best be careful.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. You can't move, can't think. Thinking is mercifully done for you. It will be a joy to serve, to die for it an honor. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
monster. Death is too good for it.
Goblins over there. Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
What's going on with that room?
Approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
A hand? Anyone?
Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. Usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Norse Lloyd as well.
I don't know what transpired exactly, but the ship broke into pieces and I suddenly found myself in freefall. As I was plummeting to certain death, I spied a glimmer quite near where I estimated my body to impact with less than savory propulsion. Recognizing this glimmer to be magical in nature, I reached out to it with a weaving of words and found myself on the other side, as it were. How about you? How did you survive the fall? Fair enough. But even so, I have the unfortunate suspicion your survival is still very much in jeopardy. Back on the ship, you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region, were you not? The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction. We're most certainly going to need a healer, and soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent. A parasite shared is a parasite halved. Or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Broken. Must have been here a while. Let's get this over with. Nothing important is ever easy. Breathe deep and move.
Thank you.
with finesse.
Victory is assured. As you wish. In striking distance.
Give up. Moving.
Waste a step.
I'm ready.
My faith will protect me.
Despite everything, let's get this over with.
on, I go.
Unleash me. Too much to bear. These mortals be. On my way.
Need to act fast. On the move.
Shall we cut and run?
Best be on my way. Easy these days.
Yeah, stay focused. What should I do?
Won't give in. If not over, then through. No traps, please. Here goes nothing.
Have you given a book? Everything all right out there? Yeah, I've got plenty more friends. Come in here and you can meet them.
Well, hello. There.
I've got a long road ahead. One day I'll catch a break.
Something over there.
Cursed to put my hands on everything.
Keep your distance, darling.
A quick rummage.
Elminster's not around, so might as well. Have my attention.
On I go.
What now?
Over here.
All right.
How many die today? How many die tomorrow?
What a day. Watch the shadows.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Have to keep going. Let's see.
I hear shouting up ahead.
We should check it out, but be careful.